Actiones nostras omnes aspirando praebeni, et albi evandu prosequere, ad cuncta nostra operatio, et praesertim hoc quod nunc aggredimur opus, a te incipiat, et per te coeptum finiatur. Quatenus sanctum nomen tuum glorificamus, et misericordia tua vitam aeternam consequamur, per Iesum Christum Dominum nostrum. Amen.
I'm delighted to welcome you to the University of St. Andrews, most appropriately on this St. Andrews Day. At this gathering, which officially is a meeting of the Senatus Academicus, we perform a number of rites of passage. Scholars become masters become doctors, and professors are inducted into their chairs. During these rituals, conducted partly in Latin in accordance with St. Andrew's tradition, I will call upon the deans in turn to present candidates for degrees from their respective faculties, and then we'll say, for example, to the student about to graduate, I raise you to the rank of Master of Arts, and to symbolize this, I place upon you this cap. To most, though, I will simply say, super te, meaning, and upon you too. The precise moment of graduation occurs when the graduate's cap touches the head of the graduate. The use of the master's cap, or baratum, is based on the procedure of the University of Paris, which was the model for St. Andrews, when we were founded at the beginning of the 15th century. In past St. Andrews graduation, this baratum was described as a piece of John Knox's briefs or trousers. Now, my immediate reaction on hearing this was to think, what an extraordinary and delightfully unique St. Andrews tradition. My second reaction was, that's pretty implausible. So with the combination of research skills and skepticism that I hope each one of you graduates acquired during your time here, I went to the library to investigate. And there I found a bill of sale for £2 Scots, which is about 16 and a half pence, for the doctor's cap for the graduation of John Arbuthnot in 1696. Arbuthnot defended his thesis on September 11, 1696. He graduated in December and went on to become the personal physician to Queen Anne. As well as a famous political satirist, it was he who was the inventor of John Bull. Now, as he graduated 124 years after Knox died, I think it is unlikely his cap was made from Knox's trousers. But this cap has nevertheless been in use for 314 years. Now, after students are awarded their degrees, members of St. Salvator's Chapel Choir will then perform before we proceed to the induction of new professors at the graduation address. The ceremony will close with a benediction by the Deputy Dean of Divinity, and the new graduates will join the academic procession. Graduation is the highlight of the university year. We're delighted that you are here to share the success of your friends and family members. I would like to welcome each one of you, and especially our six new professors. I hope that this is a memorable and a happy day for each one of you.